Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. Philip May will act as Melania Trump's escort today. But the 60-year-old Oxford graduate and the 48-year-old ex-model make a very unlikely pairing. Indeed, whereas at home, he's the one who puts the bins out, Mrs. Trump doesn't look as if she's in charge of recycling in the White House. Here, Tom Leonard matches up this odd couple. Philip May will act as Melania Trump's escort today. But the 60-year-old Oxford graduate and the 48-year-old ex-model make a very unlikely pairing. Above the two at Blenheim last night. Education raised in Norfolk and then Merseyside, he's the son of a shoe salesman and a French teacher mother. A grammar school boy, he studied history at Lincoln College, Oxford, where he was president of the Oxford Union Debating Society. Born in communist-era Yugoslavia, now Slovenia, Melania now is the daughter of a successful car dealer. Home was Savnica, a quiet industrial town, where the family was wealthy enough to enjoy ski holidays in Austria. She was a conscientious school girl and studied architecture and design. However, she gave up after a year to pursue a modeling career. Careers he has a solid but dull reputation in the city, managing pension funds for the Prudential and Deutsche Asset Management. Now a client relationship manager at the U.S. investment advisors Capital Group. Melania's modeling career, which began with a contract with a Milan agency when she was 18, has been less lucrative but certainly not dull. She once posed naked on a bare fur rug for British GQ magazine. Philip has a solid but dull reputation in the city, managing pension funds for the Prudential and Deutsche Asset Management. Melania's modeling career, which began with a contract with a Milan agency when she was 18, has been less lucrative but certainly not dull. Love at first sight. Philip married a convent-educated vicar's daughter, whereas Melania wed the son of a cutthroat New York property tycoon. Both met their future spouses at parties, but the similarity ends there. The Mays bonded at an Oxford University Conservative Association disco. He was good-looking and there was an immediate attraction. We danced, though I can't remember the music, Theresa May recalls. Trump, while separated from second wife Marla Maples in 1998, was on a date with another woman when he spotted Melania at a model agency party in New York's Kit Kat Club. He said he went crazy and asked for her telephone number. However, she, 24 years his junior, apparently told a friend that she wasn't impressed. Even so, she called him 3 days later. Wedding bells. The Mays married in 1980 at her father's church in Wheatley, Oxfordshire, after Theresa reportedly demanded an end to his foot-dragging. It was a modest affair. In the starkest contrast, the Trumps' 2005 nuptials in Palm Beach, Florida, are still considered one of the 10 most extravagant weddings ever. She wore a $100,000 Dior dress for the $1 million bash while 350 guests, including the Clintons, Elton John and Arnold Schwarzenegger, shared a £50 Grand Marnier wedding cake topped with 3,000 roses and crystal champagne, flowed like water. They were serenaded by Billy Joel and Tony Bennett. Domestic bliss. The Trumps have a son, 12-year-old Baron, to whom Mrs. Trump is devoted. The Mays were unable to have children, and Mrs. May understandably finds it difficult to discuss the subject. Philip's happy to take a back seat. There's give and take in every marriage, isn't there, he said. I get to decide when I'll take the bins out, not if I take the bins out. The Trumps have separate bedrooms at the White House and he recently confessed that he hadn't bought his wife a birthday present. The Trumps have a son, 12-year-old Baron, to whom Mrs. Trump is devoted. The Mays were unable to have children, and Mrs. May understandably finds it difficult to discuss the subject. Weekend getaways. The Mays return to her constituency home in the pretty village of Sunning, Berkshire, where both are pillars of the community. Mr. May is a server at Holy Communion on Sundays in the local Anglican church. Their house is at the end of a lane of 4- and 5-bedroom homes with gravel drives and the occasional set of electric gates. They shop at Waitrose, with Mr. May pushing the trolley. The Trumps spend most weekends at Mar-a-Lago, their sprawling pleasure palace in Palm Beach, Florida. Valued at $200 million and set in 20 acres, the 118-room jazz age chateau and private club, which charges a $200,000 joining fee, features a 20,000-square-feet ballroom and whose walls are inlaid with $7 million in gold leaf. The Trumps also have a gilt-decorated triplex apartment in Manhattan's Trump Tower and other lavish homes in Los Angeles, rural Virginia and Bedford, New York. Holiday habits. Melania has said her perfect Christmas holiday would be on a deserted tropical island with her family. However, her husband adores golf, so their breaks tend to be at one of his many luxury golf resorts. Family get-togethers are at Mar-a-Lago. The Mays enjoy walking holidays in Wales. In Snowdonia are the Brecon Beacons. They also go to the Swiss Alps, where they've hiked in August for the past 30 years. Mr. May put aside his own political ambitions to support his wife's career and acts as a sounding board for her. Mrs. Trump barely featured in her husband's election campaign and reportedly burst into tears of grief when she learned he had won. Fashion statements. Described as a sartorial wallflower, Mr. May has been mocked for his regular navy suits and sensible shoes. Mrs. Trump's problem is overdressing, say commentators. She was criticized for wearing Manolo Blahnik stilettos to visit hurricane victims and a £38,000 Dolce & Gabbana coat to the G7 summit. Her worst fashion faux pas was a parka coat emblazoned with the words, "I really don't care." Due to visit child migrant detainees. Spousal support. Mr. May put aside his own political ambitions to support his wife's career and acts as a sounding board for her. Mrs. Trump barely featured in her husband's election campaign and reportedly burst into tears of grief when she learned he had won. It took her 6 months to join her husband in Washington. Her rare expressions of a political opinion, such as suggesting his crackdown on illegal immigrants was heartless, are not always helpful. Common ground. Both are reserved, kind and polite people who are also quite shy, preferring to stay in the background. Mrs. May has credited her husband with picking her clothes and accessories. She says he's particularly good at choosing handbags. Melania has a vast collection of leather totes, clutches, fur purses, etc.